every time we ring and talk, we all, she always came with a song. And her song was Until Then.
Until Then.
Until Then, her song was. And her favorite verse was the last verse, which said, I can read it. Her favorite verse were, this weary world, with all its toil and struggle, may take its toil of misery and strife. The soul of man is like a waiting falcon. Glory to God. When it's released, it's destined for the sky.
Amen. Amen. But until then.
But until then.
My heart
will go on singing.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Until then.
With joy.
Let us carry on, brethren.
Amen.
Let us carry on until then.
Sing it.
But until then, my heart will go on singing. Until then, with joy I'll carry on. Until the day my eyes behold the city. Until the day. All its toil and struggle may take its toil of misery and strife. The soul of man is like a waiting falcon. When it's released, it's headed for the sky. But until then, my heart will go on singing. Until then, with joy and carry on. Until the day, my eyes behold the city. Until the day, God calls me home.
Let us call you home. Let's see you someday.
We'll go.
Until then,
with joy, I'll carry on. Until the day, my eyes behold the city. Until the day, God calls me home. Setoria Sasha.
Sweet Beulah Land,
across the sea, where mansions are prepared for me, and view that shining glory show, my heaven, my home, forevermore. Oh, Beulah land, sweet Beulah land, upon thy heights I long to stand, and as I look across the sea, where mansions are prepared for me, and view that shining glory show, my heaven, my home, forevermore. Zingeni le eganana la mianzu yonanzia kubonaka la kajambu kusongorile usiku. Oh, kanana rosa seka tikoleritsa kisaka senzitsiki le mananga sepansinga hatabuya zita akae kanana ritabakaya rami.
Man that is born of a woman hath but a short time to live. It is full of misery. He cometh up and is cut down like a flower, and fleeth as it were a shadow, and never continueth in one stay. And yet the steadfast love of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon those who fear him, and his righteousness unto their children's children. For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, an house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. These are the words of the living God. Let all the hearers say amen.
Amen.
God bless you and welcome today as we come to lay to rest the outer vessel of our dearly beloved Mother Julina Dunstan. I emphasize outer vessel because the true Julina, I'm convicted, is already with the Lord her Maker. She's already been called home, and we lay to rest here the medium by which we interacted. But praise be unto God for life in Christ Jesus. Praise be unto God for a lively hope that tells us that this is not it. Condolences to immediate family members. Doreen is here, Michael. To those who are abroad and watching even now. Bishop Oakton Mayer, on your birthday, I understand. Sister Vanessa Thompson and the wider family, church family, and everybody that's here. We just want to give God praise that we can at the very least do this today. I'm going to invite Minister Earl Watson to come forward and lead us in prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Can we bow our heads in prayer? Heavenly Father, eternal God, we give you all the praise and the glory today. We thank you, for this truly is a day that you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Father, we thank you, for you're the giver of life. All hope comes from thee, Lord Jesus. While our faith is in thee, Lord Jesus, for your faithfulness and your love and your mercy towards us is from everlasting to everlasting. Father, you created the heaven and the earth for your glory. And man, you said, hallelujah, was good. Hallelujah. And Father, we thank you. You giveth and you taketh away. And here we stand at this, Lord, about to commit our sister Dunstan to the ground. Father, we thank you for our sister that was so faithful, Lord Jesus. Amen. Father, we thank you for the examples that she set. We thank you, Lord God, for the joy that she brought us. Amen. Lord, we'll greatly miss her, Lord God. But Lord, we thank you. For you, Lord God, have been good to us. And you promised to keep us and to give us peace. And Father, I pray that you'll bless and comfort the family, Lord God. Those abroad and those right here now, Lord Jesus. Father, put your arms around us, O God, and help us to know that you are with us. And your rod and your staff will comfort us. Father, Lord God, help us, O God, as we go from day to day to remember, as Job said, to remember and to number our days. Hallelujah, for man has but a short time. And help us, Lord God, to do those things that please you, that in the last day we'll hear the words, "Well done, thou good and faithful servant." Father, continue to bless and keep us now as we say thank you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. God bless you.
Hallelujah.
We're going to have our scripture reading right now from Deacon David Lewis, nephew of Sister Dunstan, which will come from Psalm 23.
Just want to send my condolences to all of the family and from my mom, Mother Louise, at this time. Scripture is taken from Psalms 23, and it reads, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, my rod and my staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever," here in the regions of God's word.
Amen. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Yesterday evening we were in church, wanted to sing and couldn't sing, but today we're outdoors, so you are free to give it everything you have in the great triumphant morning. God bless you. Sing along.
And the day in Christ shall rise, we'll be changed to life immortal in the twinkling of an eye, and meet Jesus in the skies. We shall all rise to meet him, we shall all go to greet him in the morning when the day in Christ shall rise. We shall all rise to meet him, we shall all
Somebody say praise the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah. Glory be to God. God bless you. God bless you. This time we're going to be favored with some words of comfort from our pastor, Janet Watson. Give her a round of applause as she comes.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Greetings in the precious name of Jesus. Once again, we're here to give God the glory and to give God the praise and to leave some words of encouragement with the family and the friends and the extended family. I know that our Bishop Mayor and our sister Vanessa is watching, and greetings to you. And I'm going to share these comforting words with you all. Hallelujah. And you know, I was thinking, what do you say in times like these? Perhaps even, what would I want to hear? And I turned to St. John chapter 14 and 1-4. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. And these words to me bring comfort, because Jesus was talking himself. It came from his mouth. If I go, then I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, you're going to be also. That's comforting to know, because Mother Dunstan believed in those words. So therefore, the Lord has come, received her, and she's where he is. And we know that where he is, where Jesus is, there is joy and peace. So we are assured that mom, that auntie, that grandma is safe and happy and well cared for and praising her God. That's comforting to know. Yes, weep. Jesus wept for Lazarus. And yet he is the resurrection and the life. So it's our humanity that would weep. So our weeping, it may endure for a night, but joy is going to come in the morning. Amen. Our joy is knowing that she is with the Lord. Yes, you're going to physically, Bishop Mayor, Sister Vanessa, Doreen, you're going to physically miss mom and auntie and grandma. But Mother Dunstan put some things in place. She put some things in place before she left us. So listen to this. Psalms 71 and verse 18. Now also, when I am old and gray-headed, O God, forsake me not until I have shewed thy strength unto this generation and thy power to everyone that is to come. That was like Mother Dunstan saying, yeah, I'm gray-haired, I'm old, hallelujah, but I'm leaving something. She set you up for life because she had been obedient to the voice of the Lord. And the Lord will show mercy and blessings to generations and to generations. She's gone, but what lack ye? What do you lack? You have provision. You have protection. You have peace. You have love. What do you lack? You as children are blessed. The grandchildren are blessed. The great-grandchildren are blessed. The great-great-grandchildren are blessed because of the obedience, because of what she set up and left from generation to generation. The last little baby is blessed. Hallelujah. Because you know what? God honors his promises. So, after all that is said and done, and if you believe what has just been said, you can go home, kick off your shoes, put your feet up, hallelujah, reflect, and say, Mom, Auntie, Grandma, I am assured and I am secured for life because of your faithfulness. Be blessed. Hallelujah. Be comforted with these words in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Bless the Lord. God bless you, Pastor Janet. Thank you for your words of encouragement, words of blessing from the Holy Scriptures. Bless the Lord. Mother Dunstan did entrust me with a couple of things to make sure what happened when the time come. And one of them was to make sure it's not a eulogy where read out where she born and when she born and all. Yeah. And we have done that. We're now going to have Celebration of Life read by Sister Doreen. Give her a hand, please.
Celebration of Life. Mother Julie Dunstan, Julie Brown, Aunt Julie. We celebrate her life. She was a God-fearing spiritual woman who loved the Lord and served him with passion. She continued in prayer and praise and worship up to the end of her journey. We celebrate her life. A dear mother, mother-in-law, grandmother, great-grandmother and a great-great-grandmother, an aunt, grand-aunt, a woman who, when widowed, raised her children with the help of God. She loved her family, fondly known as Aunt Julie, by relatives who loved and respected her. We celebrate her life. In August 2010, Mum was awarded for her contribution to the city of Wolverhampton. She was a mentor, community activist, a champion. She played an important part in setting up the Motaz project in 1981. And that was the first black-led community project in Wolverhampton. She served on the management board, and she also served on the management board for Hibiscus House. She was passionate about helping the vulnerable, and in her later life, she was supported by the Moorland Trust Community Service. We celebrate her life. A skilled woman, she enjoyed crocheting, knitting, cooking, dressmaking, and she even tried piano lessons. She was a teacher, teaching students trichem, which was liquid embroidery. She was a nursing student, but was unable to complete the course. And as I said, she always said it was because of us as young children. She attended needlecraft classes, and attended computer classes up to just a few years ago. She loved to sing with the women's choir. Also a soloist, singing songs such as The Grumbling Song, I Keep Listening. She sang duets in her younger days with her son Hopeton, especially when Forward Still, Then Forward Still, 'Tis Jehovah's Will. She loved to dance unto the Lord. She was an actress, having roles with the Women's Ministry Drama Group. She was a poet, reciting poems from memory up to December 2019 at a carol service for the elderly. We celebrate her life. A traveller, attending church conferences around the UK with her daughters Vanessa and Doreen. She visited her home country, Jamaica, St. Lucia, St. Kitts, and Nevis, a country she always wanted to visit. We actually also visited Antigua. It was only for a few hours because we didn't get out the airport, but we appreciated being there and discussing iguanas with some of the people there. She also visited Canada, where family was, and America with her dear friend, Sister Kerr. We enjoyed and look forward to our girl times out, having a happy meal or KFC. My brother also looked forward to those times out when he came over, and my sister. We celebrate her life. Mom had a great sense of humor, making us laugh even when she was sick. She was blessed to be surrounded by caring family, amazing church brethren, great friends, neighbors, and for this, she was always grateful. We celebrate her life.
God bless you.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing, sing his mercy and his grace. Yeah.
Amen.
All right, can we do it one more time and really go for it this time? One, two, three. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victorious Lord. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Amen. Anybody want to shout victory? Shout it again, victory. Bless the name of the Lord. God is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. This time, it is my pleasure to introduce one of our seniors in the gospel. I was preaching the gospel when I was a little boy in shorts causing trouble. But he's here with us today, and we hand over to him, who's going to just give closing remarks and then the committal. Okay? Elder Jacob Harriet, sorry. Come, sir, come.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And to our bishop and members of the family, greeting in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
And to those which are here, some are in America, Canada, Sister Maureen and husband is here. We thank God for you all.
Amen.
And thank God to be a part of the team here this afternoon. Amen. Now, a strong woman has been passed away, Amen. But one thing I can say, she prepared for departure.
Amen.
And since she prepared for departure, she have somewhere to go.
Amen.
It's no good dress up with everything
right.
and have nowhere to go. Mm. But she have a home in Jesus.
Amen.
Now I first met her, it's a long time ago before son was born, about 1957. We met at a rally, and she was a member of the choir, youthful choir. She was young that time, and the performance was very much good. And when the next day, we could only talk about the sister from Burnt Savannah, because the performance was good, so she was the talk about the town. Then the night, now her pastor, Elder Bennett, preached the message, taken from St. John 11, verse 39. Take ye away the stone. Then the song that was singing, I catch few words out of the chorus. And you know, I was even trying to sing this song before I came here, but it got mixed up. But it's a long time. But let me just give it in 2 minutes. I bound for that beautiful city that the Lord has prepared for his own, where the saints of all the ages shall sing around the white throne. Sometime I grow homesick for heaven and the joy that there be to behold. What a joy that will be when my Savior I see in that beautiful city of God.
Amen, 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 amen.
I met her in England again, and all that I have to say to her was the song, was the remembrance of what happened in that rally that day. And God bless you all. She bound for that city, so therefore she died with joy, hoping that someday the stone will be rolled away. Death and his power will be rolled away. Thank you, thank you, thank you. in the wonderful name of Jesus. Now at this time, we have to get rid of all these greens and get in there the ground. Dress up so well with the white coffin, I'm going to throw dirt on it. My, but nevertheless, is the way apostles trod, and my brother shall live again. My sister shall live again. Jesus said, your brother
That's right.
Shall rise again in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Shall I carry on with the committal then?
Yes, you can.
Okay, yes. Give Elder Harris, please, a round of applause. Under the current guidelines, we're not allowed to do our usual process of backfilling. So what will happen is we will do the committal now, and then we will need to leave the cemetery. The graveside attendants will come and do the backfilling for us. But the cemetery is open from 4 till 7 for anybody who wants to come back after and particularly decorate it how we want it to be decorated. Okay, it's just the circumstances that we're in. Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For as much as the spirit of the departed hath returned to the God who gave it, we therefore commit Sister Julina's body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the resurrection and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose coming in glorious majesty to judge the world. The earth and the sea shall give up their dead. The corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed, made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working, whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. And can we just join together, please, with our final prayer, the Lord's Prayer, as he taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God bless you all, brethren, family, friends. Thank God for Eagle Vision, who facilitated the streaming of this service and recording of this service. Thank God for every participation that has been made today. We prepare now to go. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all now and forever. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you, everybody. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory one more time. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. God bless you, everybody. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
First of all, I want to thank God for my mother. I give God all the glory, praise, and honor for blessing me to have the most wonderful and caring mother. Mother raised me all by herself, and she taught me life-surviving skills in Jamaica. She was a responsible and dedicated mother. She was my first educator and did such a great job that I spent only a week in first grade and was promoted to the second grade, then later skipped third grade and later promoted to the fourth grade. Thank God for mother's early childhood education. She was my saved spiritual advisor who made me go to church, especially to Sunday school. At Sunday school, I heard the teaching of hell's fire and was baptized this year, making 65 years ago. She was indeed a pillar of strength to me. I will surely miss my yearly pilgrimage to England to help and to be with my mother. On behalf of my sisters, Vanessa and Doreen, my wife, Annie, my children, Claudette, Hopeton Jr., and Kevin, and my grandchildren, I thank everyone at the hospital and at the Everly Care Center. I thank the pastor and saints of Mom's Church and the many friends and loved ones who were there for Mother during her illness. What an honor that the funeral director unknowingly chose my birth date, 17th July, for my mother to be laid to rest. Rest in peace, Mother. I love you.
So often you hear about friction between mother-in-laws and their daughter-in-laws. I can truly say there was never one moment of friction between me and Mother Dunstan. She was not just a mother-in-law to me. She was a mother. If there was ever a decision to be made between my husband and I could always be assured she would be on my side. She was a jewel. She was a beautiful woman of God, a strong woman of God. Rest in peace, Mother. I love you. You're beautiful. Thank God for you.
Greetings to everyone. First of all, on behalf of myself, my husband Michael, and my two daughters, Yolanda and Christina, I would like to thank everyone who has prayed, called, sent a text, WhatsApp message, Facebook message, or a card during our season of bereavement. We have surely felt the warm love and caring from everyone. My brother Hopeton and sister Doreen, we really appreciate it. I thank God for the life of my mother, Julie Dunstan, or fondly known as Aunt Julie. What a queen, what a lady who established nothing but the highest values in our lives. She was our spiritual guide. Church on Sundays, no joking. She earnestly covered her children with prayer. She was our financial advisor, advising us to save your money. She was our social worker. Her words of wisdom would not be realized until I became an adult. She was our music director, taught us many, many songs, some with actions, some with three-part harmony. She was our seamstress, making a few dresses and summer uniforms. She was our chef. She would bake cornmeal and sweet potato pudding. We tried many times to write down the ingredients, but how do you write down a little of this, a little sugar, a little flour? It was a great challenge. She was our in-house entertainer. She always had a joke or some parable to tell. She was our nurse, nursing all three of us as we ventured through the various stages of whatever illness we were suffering from. There's so much more I could say for someone who spent over 90 years on this earth. her story could go on. But for now, my main tribute of my mother is that she was an example of someone who was sold out for serving the Lord. This is the story that needs to be told, how she depended on God for every aspect of her life. Rest on, Mom. We shall meet again, not on this side, but in glory.
Greetings in the name of Jesus Christ to my brothers and sisters, to Bishop Hope Demir, Lady Vanessa, Lady Doreen. On behalf of the Rawlinson family and my sister Corrine in Jamaica, please accept our condolences. Today is the day we join with you in celebrating the life and legacy of Mother Dunstan. I remember on her 90th birthday, Melissa, myself, and Xavier went to England to celebrate with her. This lady was so grateful, and she was very kind to my grandson, make him so comfortable and at ease. I remember she taught him a song, "Whose side are you leaning on? Leaning on the Lord's side." I shall always remember that. And that's the way she lived her life. A week before her passing, I called Sister Vanessa, and she was on a conference call with her sibling, Bishop Mayer and Lady Doreen. She heard Vanessa say, "Blossom." And she asked Vanessa to call me. I took it as such an honor to know that she was speaking with her children, yet she remembered me. I shall always remember her love and kindness. I shall miss her dearly. But one thing I realize, that love is stronger than death. May God bless you all. Rest in peace, Aunt Julie.
Greeting to everyone in the name of Jesus. My name is Lionel A. Guthrie, Bishop of Canada, and I'm pleased to have this opportunity to pass a few words of condolence to the family and friends of Julie, a friend of mine. We go a way back and we worship at number 3 Brook Road, where Mother Bailey was a pastor. She also was a Sunday school teacher for me when we ministered at one of the locations under Pastor Bailey. Julie moved to England, and for a while we was not in contact with each other, but two of our children, now Bishop Mayer and also Vanessa Thompson, we were able to be kept informed of her whereabouts. Julie is a good friend of mine, as I said before, and we all grieve for pastor. One thing she and I had in common, that we were both born the same year, 1928. I trust that the friends and family will be comforted knowing that Julie is a child, was a child of the Lord, and she is in the hand of our Savior. Julie, rest in peace. May the Lord of heaven bless. I encourage the family and friend to keep close to each other, praying one for another. The Lord will continue to bless and show favor in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. We give God thanks for this day, for this blessed opportunity to encourage the family of Mother Dunstan. We thank God for her. Amen. We know that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. To Bishop Mayer and to Sister Vanessa and Doreen, we want you to know that we stand with you in this hour of bereavement, and know that God, hallelujah, He can heal all the pain. We're going to miss Mother Dunstan. We've known her for almost 50 years. Amen. And what a joy it has been. She has enriched our lives with her word of wisdom and her mother caring nature. She was a wonderful mother in Zion. And we thank God for her. And again, we encourage Bishop Mayer and Sister Vanessa and also Doreen. Keep your head up. We're standing with you in this hour.
Praise the Lord to our beloved Bishop, our brother in love, not brother in law, but brother in love, to Vanessa and to Doreen. As my husband has said, please know that you are in our hearts, you're in our thoughts. We're praying with you. As he has said, Mother Dunstan has been such a great encouragement to us down through the years. We know that you're going to miss her, but as he said, we're praying for you, and we know that God will comfort and strengthen you during this time. God bless you.
Our King and Redeemer is He, our Lord and our Savior from sin, and the beam from the star that shone from afar lights the pathway that leads unto Him. Thank you.
And then she would instruct our sister Sharon to gather the children together and for them to sing, "Whose side are we leaning on?" And anyone who knows this song knows that there are different actions, such as jumping and clapping and running. And after the children had sung a couple of rounds of this song, she would say, "Bring the young people up. Young people, come up." "Who are your young people?" "Us." And we had to get up. And we would be there running, jumping, clapping. Yes. We remember. We remember. And it was such a blessing. Such a blessing. She would pull everybody together. She was truly leaning on the Lord's side. She was a woman of great substance and faith, never giving up. No matter what the church went through, whatever she went through physically, and she would call me sometime and say, "See this finger? It's not talking to me today." She had bad fingers, and so sometimes the blood wasn't circulating, and so it wouldn't do as it was told. But she was never discouraged. She was never discouraged. She always trusted and depended on the Lord. And Proverbs 31, 25 to 26 says, "Strength and honor are in her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She openeth her mouth and wisdom, and her tongue is the law of kindness." Mother Dunstan, she has run the race. She's kept the faith. And now she's just waiting for a crown of life. God bless you, brethren, as we reflect today on the life of one of our supermothers, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord to our overseer, our pastor, ministers, saints of God's friends. Wonderful greetings in the name of Jesus. It's just truly an honor to be here this evening, just to say a few words on behalf of my mother. I didn't truly know what her name was, because she always told us it was Julie. But we always used to call her Sister Julie Dunstan. And it was only when I went to the hospital and the nurses were calling her, asking me who Julie was, that I realized that her name was Julina. Such a beautiful name. And truly, she was a rose in the garden of God's glory. She was one who liked to make herself known. She was never a wallflower. If Mother Dunstan was in the house, she knew she was in the house. She always made herself known, and she always wanted to know everyone that was around. She made it her business to find out who was who and what they were doing. And even when I went to the hospital ward to tell them that she passed, one of the nurses said, "Oh, I'm so sorry, to give my condolences to the family." So they send their condolences from the ward at New Cross. And they also said, "Do you know, one of the nights that she was here, she kept on saying, 'Nurse, nurse, nurse, nurse,' and kept on going to her and couldn't find out what she wants." So I said to her, "Well, what does she want?" She said, "I didn't want anything. I just like calling nurse, nurse." And so she just did it for fun because she liked to do it. Oh, praise be to God. But what a blessing to know a woman of God that loved the Lord. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Firstly, let me give an apology for my husband, who is at work at the moment. But to Bishop Kingsburg, to our pastor, and all you wonderful saints of the Most High God. We have known Mother Dunstan for approximately 6 years at Grace Apostolic. And during that period of time, we have seen how dedicated she was in serving the Lord. No matter how she was feeling, she would still attend church on a Sunday. She usually, you know, she comes in and Mother Dunstan is Mother Dunstan. She's a well-loved woman and, you know, she sits there or she'll ask you, can you help me to take my coat off? And she's, oh, my arm is just not feeling well. But we did understand because, you know, even when you're not old in age, you still have problems with pains because much younger than her and we are having problems, but to God be the glory. She was a virtuous woman, and the scripture said, who can find a virtuous woman? Mother Dunstan, as one of the mothers of grace, she was inspirational to us. She was encouraging. She, you know, there was that push to go on. In spite of the pain, there was that push. And, you know, we value having her there. But, you know, now that she's gone, I'm sure we'll be looking around and we'll be reminiscing about our Mother Dunstan, a lovely woman of God. During morning service, she would always open up with a song. You know, we may be sitting there faffing about, but Mother Dunstan, she just gets straight to it and she would raise the chorus. She would raise the song and then we know we'll have to join in because we are not just there to sit and observe. We're there to worship the Most High God. And that's what she encouraged us to do, which was one of the attributes of Mother Dunstan. It's about singing to the glory of God. She was funny, especially when she tells us stories. And as Pastor rightly said, when she, you know, recited those poems, you know, you were amazed. And we'd sit there, oh my God. But that reminds me of my grandma who passed away at 101 years old. At age 100, when we went for a celebration, and she reminisced the poem from she was a child, we were in absolute shock. And Mother Dunstan reminds me in that respect of my grandmother. You know, she also used to take, we used to take her home after church and on occasions pay her visits. And even after church, you know, sometimes when we take her home, we'd sit down with her. And even if we tried to go a bit too quick, Mother Dunstan was Mother Dunstan. A little chat, and you know we had to sit. And, you know, that was so nice. And after, sometimes even when we get up to leave, we feel so much, you know, like, oh, it's such a shame that we have to leave her. But we enjoyed her company, and I'm sure she did enjoy her company. You know, Mother Dunstan was just Mother Dunstan. Sometimes even my husband, she'd call him, and he'd do little errands for her, like probably going to pick up something at the shop for her. Even when Bishop Mayer came, and I know Minister wasn't available to take him to the barber's, and she rang him. And he was there available. She was just Mother Dunstan. And you couldn't say no. You just have to say yes to Mother Dunstan. Not that she would have been, you know, offended, but we were just happy to help. Especially with Sister Doreen being away in London, Minister Michael and Sister Vanessa and Bishop Mayer being away. It was so nice. We acted as a family to her. And I'm sure she had regarded us as families, you know, but to God be the glory. We thank God for her life because her presence made us feel so happy and happy to serve the Lord, happy to go on. The Lord has called her home at a time as this. And it is the Lord's will that she is gone on to glory, and we magnify the name of the Lord for her. May her soul continue to rest in peace. And it was a privilege to have known her. She's gone, but not forgotten. Praise the Lord.
First of all, President, I speak on behalf of my wife and myself. And there's not really much more to say. The sister, Janice, Sister Anne, and Pastor have said quite a bit. Mother Dunstan, I have known for 50 plus years. Wife will know her a little less. And when I say I know her, see her in church, didn't know her until the last 10 years or so. What has she got? An absolute wicked sense of humor, is all I can say. So her sense of humor is really, really wicked, with that little laughter when she comes out with it. So it was quite a blessing, actually, when we pick her up and we're going to church and when we're coming back. She would gale us with tales. Looking at her date of birth, I'm not quite certain because she also had two birthdays we have. And I'm still not certain which one is which. It is there. It was a pleasure to do things for her. I know her sister Anna says, you know, if Molly is not available to do anything, I know she'll go to Brother Jones, and if Brother Jones isn't available, she'll ask Molly on the channel. The sad part basically is that we know things, life is inevitable, some things in life is inevitable. But when the inevitable occurs, it is difficult to reconcile with the reality of life. And Mother Dunstan is gone. And to some extent, I think when I was speaking here, I wasn't here for quite some time. And I always says, there are certain people I worry about when I leave the country, because I really want to come back and see them. And I lost her, and I lost a sister, another mother in Dudley. She was 90 odd. And I really missed them both. But you know, as some said, she's lived her life. And what I've seen of her, she made her calling and election short. I'm not crying. I'm not sad, in a sense, because she's going on to better things. And if, as long as she's there with the better things, then why should I cry? She's gone. I think as Bishop done all this, you know, I've looked over and I've seen better land. So Sister Doreen, Brother Michael, be strong. To Sister Vanessa and Bishop Peter, I know you're all strong. You'll be up. We will meet again. So Sisters Vanessa and Mother Dunstan, rest in peace and God bless.
Glory to God. You can say it a little bit louder. Hallelujah. You can say it a little bit louder. That sounds a little bit better. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I greet Bishop Peter Queensborough, the pastor, and all the wonderful saints. It's an honor to stand here to talk about Sister Dunstan. Mother Dunstan, I was a young child when I first met her. And I just want to share this little story that I experienced I had with her. I left church when I was about 18, 19. And one morning I decided I'm going to get up and go to church. I don't know what took hold of me, but I thought I'll go to church. So me and I took my younger brother, went to church, and we sat, if you know Mount Shana, we sat at the back, right by the door. And if everybody knows Mother Dunstan, she used to sit two rows on the right-hand side, left-hand side. So service was going on, we'd come in late, very late, and we were just sitting at the back, me and my brother listening, and then the altar call came. And we looked and we were talking to her. Next minute, we felt a hand on our shoulder. And I'm like, who is this? And I heard this voice say, would you like me to pray for you? And we looked around and it was Mother Dunstan. And we was like, how on earth does she see us if we're sitting at the back and she's sitting at the front? And I thought, that's just impossible. And We both said very politely, it's okay, we're fine where we are. And if you know Mother Dunstan, Mother Dunstan doesn't take no for an answer. So Mother Dunstan says, come. So she grabbed both of her handbags, she was the police, and marched us up the front of the... and laid us down at the altar. And you know, saints of God, I'm not saying it, I felt good about it. But as I've grown, I've realized the commitment that she has made. The songwriter says, I've made my choice forever. And Mother Dunstan had made her choice. She wasn't just, she's not just going herself, she's bringing somebody else with her. And I'm so glad that she did. During Mother Dunstan's exit plan was perfect because she has made it. I believe it in my heart. And as I look at her and remember her, that's the thought that came to me. Her exit plan from this world is assured because she's given her whole life. And I just want to encourage you, make sure your exit plan is at the standard that your mother's is, and you will make it. God bless you.
Reads as follows, 1 Corinthians 15 verses 51 to 58. Quickly in your hearing, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall we be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which give us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen.
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 Even though, I am Delroy Brown, grandnephew of Aunt Julie, and I'm here on behalf of my dad, Simeon Brown, who can't be here today due to certain circumstances of travelling. And all I can say about Aunt Julie, she was like one of the best aunties, always bubbling, always giving. She always asking about the family. She's a family person. She loves it when the family's around, and she never leaves nobody out. And there's loads I can say about her, be here all night. She's a very happy person, I can say. You know, she always looked out for all of us when we was growing up from young. Always enjoyed the cake and the can of ginger beer and the meals. She always asked if you're hungry, you've got dinner. She's always like welcoming, you know. So it's a sad thing that today is a very sad day, but as previous people have said, we should be kind of happy because she's a bubbly person, so we should be down. But I know that if she was here now, she'd be loud. The whole family's like that, like jokers. The Brown family's in jokers. For her brothers who've passed away, the walls were all like that. Like, fully, like, always funny. When you're around him, you can't stop laughing. As I said, she'll never be forgotten. And it's a big shock that I'm here today. But it's one of these things. Anyway, that's all I've got to say.
Bishop Queensborough, Pastor, Beryl and Janet Watson, To God be the glory, great things he's done. God, amazing grace endure forever. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no ill. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. My condolences to the Dunstan, immediate family and extended family. And forgive me if I sound as tears in my heart. It is. I've known this great lady for a good 40 years or more, spending 5 days a week, 10 till 3 p.m., for 20 years. Mother had an appointment, much better than we can offer her, faithful to her last minute on earth. I visited her in hospital, and as I approached her room, her family and a couple of friends said, Sister Padme, she's not talking and has not spoken. I cannot remember how long they told me that she wasn't speaking for. Although she was not speaking, we think she can hear us. Permission given to me to speak to her. In my mind, I was thinking, I've seen her. I will now just leave and let she rest. But this time, the voice in the room became stronger. Sister Pat, go whisper in her ears. Mother D is a woman that I like, that likes obedience and good manners. Sister Pat May, I will never forget her until the day I die. Mother Hopin, her eyes looked up at me as I whisper into her ears with the most beautiful smile ever on her face, and she said to me in her Patois accent, Padme, is now you are come, and something else, like, you take long. I don't remember her exact word. Then she said to me, Sister Pat, this is a woman who was not speaking, I was told. I am ready to go home to my Father in heaven, and I've told them. I assume that she meant her children. The way Mother greeted me that day, I grew 10 feet tall and more. She made me felt so important that I began wondering if she was waiting for me to come to say goodbye. It was a good job that I visit her. What a privilege to know such a woman. I was able to knock her door anytime. She was always welcome, and every time I go, get up to go, she would find something to keep me longer. You see, I'm one of those old-fashioned Jamaicans. I don't make appointments to visit. I just turn up, you shut the door, or you take it and leave it. Thank you, Mother, for never shutting the door in my face. As an unsaved woman, she prayed for me, tormented me, and get serious on me about my soul. She was not afraid to get serious about the human soul. So I tell you today, I summed up Mother Dunstan. She has been preserved to the pages of scriptures. In every scripture that was written down many thousand years ago by a man who was not even a part of the Dunstan family. His name was King Lommel. And even though he did not know our Mother Dunstan, he described her perfectly when he described the perfect woman. Proverbs 31:10. She's a wonderful wife, a noble character. Who can find? She's worthy far more than rubies. She brings him good, no harm, all the days of her life. She select wool and flax and work with eager hands. She's like the merchant ship bringing her food from afar off. She gets up while she's still dark. She provides food for her family and portions for her servant girls. Amazing cook. There was no frozen dinner or fast food to be found at her house, maybe in her later years. She was always doing what she could with the gift God has given her to make her house a home and to bless the lives of all who she knew. So for these, and a host of other reasons, Proverbs 31:16, she consider a field and buy it. out of her earnings. She plant a vineyard. She set about her work vigorously. Her arms are strong and her task. She sees that her trading is profitable. And I'm coming down now. And her lamp does not go out at night. In her hand she holds a staff and grasps the spindle with her finger. She opens her arms to the poor and extend her hand the need. The needy. She rise and call her blessed. Her children rise and call her blessed. Many women do noble things, but you surpass them all, Mother Dunstan. She makes her linen garment and sell them and supply the merchants. She clothes with strength and dignity. She can laugh at the days to come. She speaks with wisdom and faithful instruction is on her tongues. She watches over the affair of her household and does not eat bread. You see, she knew the Lord's words and she never forgot. Her word was hidden in her heart. She never forget his promise. So rest now, you woman of noble character. You are blessed and your deeds follow you. Dunstan family, be comforted today as you remember her long life. Rejoice in the strong family she built. Thank you very much for listening to these words. This was a woman of character, a wonderful woman of God. God bless you. Thank you.
Aunt Julie. Aunt Julie was a great auntie. Not someone to be argued with, though. She could command this and command that, as I've heard it being said a couple of times already this evening, and you would have to do it because Aunt Julie said it. Now, she won't be able to send David and I off on any errands to buy fish and chips for her and our boys. She won't be able to send David to this place or that place to buy this or that. Aunt Julie used to amaze us with her memory. Razor sharp, knew everyone and everything that was going on. She didn't miss a beat. She used to love our boys, Devontae and Deshaun. She would have this smile on her face whenever she would see them, wherever we were. Devontae especially loved Aunt Julie. When he got baptized in November last year, we had to make a special trip to go to see her so he could tell her in person. I also found it quite interesting, Pastor Janet, when you mentioned that she would call the children to sing "Whose Side Are We Leaning On?" because Devontae and Deshaun had to give a private performance, remember Doreen? And she made them sing "Whose Side Are We Leaning On?" and they're a bit reluctant, and she insisted, and they had to sing. And as you said, Pastor Janet, they had to do the actions. And I think Doreen, you had to record it or something. Yes. So like I said, Aunt Julie would give the command and you had to follow it to the letter. There was a time when we visited Aunt Julie and she called me into her bedroom to help her fold this everlastingly long curtain. And we folded this net curtain for ages. I think, Doreen, she said that you normally did that for her. I remarked to her, I'd never seen a curtain so long. Looking back, it was good to spend that time with Aunt Julie, as I had no idea that that would be the last time I would spend a one-to-one with her. Now it's time for Aunt Julie to rest, free from pain. Sometimes when we visited, she'd be in so much pain, but she would be cheerful, and seeing the boys would be like tonic and a pain relief for her. No more will we have the opportunity to stand around her and hold hands and pray with her while she covered us before we left. Aunt Julie, you are now free from all pain and suffering, healed and made whole again. A new body awaits. Good night. We love you and we will miss you.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Greeting our Bishop, Pastor Watson, Minister Watson. Let me offer my condolences to Doreen, Michael and the family. Praise the Lord. Especially at this difficult time, where we can't give Mother Dunstan a proper send-off. Praise the Lord. We pray that the comfort of the Lord will be upon you. Amen. I'm not going to go over what's already been said. A lot has been said and I know time is going. But I'd just like to say just a minute on Mother Dunstan before I read two tributes from the church. Mother Dunstan's desire was to make heaven her home. That was her desire. And Mother Dunstan lived her life as if that was her desire. Amen? There was no messing with Mother Dunstan. And if you was in the church and you was messing, you wouldn't want to meet Mother Dunstan. Amen? She believed Philippians 4:13, which says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Many years ago at Eastfield, she gave myself, Pastor Watson, I'm not sure if you recall, she gave us a sheet, and it says, don't give up. And there was another bird, which captures another bird. Amen? And the bird that was captured, though the head was in her mouth, was still trying to strangle that bird. And I've still got that sheet to this day. Amen? She lived her life as if she wanted to make heaven her home. Amen. Time is going, so I'm just going to read these two tributes from two of our seniors from Bethel Apostolic Ministries. Sister Joy would love to be here, but she can't because of the children, but she sends her love. Amen. Deacon Lear says, Mother Dunstan was a helpful person. Thinking back to Old Hall Street and Mount Shiloh, she worked alongside them, united in aim and in her heart. At that time, there appeared to be no leader among them. I say this because they were united in everything that they did. She would never command. She would say, can we do this? But would not tell you what to do. Mother Dunstan was a person that worked from the back, decently and correctly. She was meek, humble, and sociably very friendly. And that's from Deacon Lear. Amen. Mother Ennis says, Sister Dunstan was a strong-willed person, a very special woman of God. She was someone who always was trying to help other people. She was able to interpret the Bible in a way that gave people joy and inspiration. Conversations with Sister Dunstan were always full of humor, as we've heard. There were times that we would talk on the phone and share stories that would make us laugh. One time she told a joke about how the hearing consultant wanted to check her hearing, something which she found hilarious. As she says, her hearing was very good, and she could hear the trains that passed by her house ever so clearly. I thank God for Mother Dunstan, her life, and the times we spent together. To God be the glory from Sister Ennis. Amen. Can we give Mother Dunstan a hand? She was a true mother of the church, known by all and respected by all. God bless you, in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. At this time, we're going to have a third scripture reading by Joanne Watson.
Scripture reading is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 to 8. To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. Here endeth the reading of God's holy word.
Amen. Amen. Shall we give God the glory? It's a celebration of life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Greetings to Bishop Windsor, Pastor Janet, Minister Earl. Greetings to everybody. So good to see you all. Celebration of life. First of all, I'm going to read a tribute from Paz Plummer. I don't know if everybody knows him, but he's a community from the community, and he was with Mommy for years, and he really couldn't make it tonight. He says, Mrs. Dunstan is an exceptional lady. She was gracious, generous, and a passionate giver to the African Caribbean community of Wolverhampton. In the setting up of the Motaz project in 1981, she was there at the inception along with Bishop Homer Plummer. For those of you who may not have heard of the Motaz Lane project, it was the first black-led community project in Wolverhampton to establish a day center for black elderly and a youth training to cater for the needs of unemployed Afro-Caribbean young people. Initially, the day center was based at the Salvation Army Citadel building in Cleveland Road, and the training center for young people based at Motaz Lane, Wensfield. Subsequently, all activities, the day center and the training scheme was moved to premises in Raglan House, Raglan Street. Mrs. Dunstan was a key player to the Motaz project enterprise. She served for many years as director, trustees on the management board. She was engaging and an acting member of the management, and also in the running and organizing of the day center, its day-to-day activities such as craft classes, day trips, day devotion, and the serving of meals to members who required help. Mrs. Dunstan's contribution to the community went beyond the work of Motaz Lane Project Day Center. As a matter of fact, she was there at the Motaz Lane Project when Hibiscus House Sheltered Housing Scheme in U Street, Graysley, was conceptualized. Mrs. Dunstan actually served on the Hibiscus House inaugural management board as one of its directors. As director, she was part of the negotiation team which secured the initial housing corporation funding, which led to the design and building of 10 self-contained flats units in U Street, Graysley. After the 10 self-contained units were built and handed over by the Normid Housing Association to the Hibiscus Board of Management, Mrs. Dunstan continued to serve on the Board of Management and also on the House Committee, subcommittee of the board. The House Committee had the responsibility to interview applicants requiring residency, as well as having the responsibility for liaising, supporting the manager and housekeeper, and as a reference point of contact to residents for discussing issues of concern. This was a position that she served well. Mrs. Dunstan was a passionate, charming, loving, kind person, and a person of unquestionable integrity. You are going to be missed, Mrs. Dean, no questions about this. Friends, colleagues, and members of the former Murtaugh's Project, Hibiscus Housing Association, and the Wolverhampton African Caribbean Foundation Trust, thank you for your many years of service. God bless, and may your soul rest in peace as you go forward to meet our Maker. Amen. And that's that was from Paz Plummer. Mommy was very much involved in the community. Amen. So this is the celebration of life. Mother Julina Dunstan, Julie Brown, Aunt Julie. We celebrate her life. A God-fearing spiritual woman who loved the Lord and served him with passion. She continued in prayer and praise and worship up to the end of her journey. We celebrate her life. A dear mother, mother-in-law, grandmother, great-grandmother, and great-great-grandmother. A woman who, when widowed, raised her children with the help of God. She loved her family, fondly known as Aunt Julie, by relatives who loved and respected her. We celebrate her life. A mentor, community activist, a champion, she played an important part in the setting up of the Murtaugh's Project in 1981, the first Black-led community project in Wolverhampton, and she served there on the management board. She also served on the management board for the Hibiscus House. She was very passionate about helping the vulnerable, and in her later life, she herself was supported by the Moorland Trust Community Service. We celebrate her life. A skilled woman, she enjoyed knitting, crocheting, dressmaking. She even tried piano lessons. She was a teacher, teaching students Tri-Chem, which was liquid embroidery, remember? She was a nursing student, but was unable to complete the course. And she said that was because of us when we were small children. But anyway, she attended needlecraft classes and attended computer classes up to a few years ago. She loved to sing with the women's choir. Also a soloist, singing songs such as The Grumbling Song, and sang duets in the younger days in Jamaica with her son, Houghton. She loved to dance unto the Lord. She was an actress, having roles with the Women's Ministry Drama Group. A poet, reciting poems from memory up to December 2019 at a carol service for the elderly. We celebrate her life. A traveler, attending church conferences around the UK with her daughters, Vanessa and Doreen. She visited her home country, Jamaica, St. Lucia, St. Kitts, and Nevis, a country she always wanted to visit. We actually also visited Antigua for a few hours, although we never left the airport, but we stayed in there talking to people about iguanas. She also visited family in Canada and America with her dear friend, Sister Kerr. We enjoyed and look forward to our girl times out, having a Happy Meal or KFC. And she enjoyed those times out with the family as well, especially when my brother came from America every year. We celebrated her life. Mom had a great sense of humor, making us laugh, even while she was sick. She was blessed to be surrounded by caring family, amazing church brethren, great friends and neighbors. And for this, she was grateful. We celebrate her life. Praise the Lord. And amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. We celebrate her life. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Greetings in the precious name of Jesus. Giving God thanks for all of you. Thanking Bishop Queensborough for his hospitality and for hosting this special service. In these unprecedented times, there's a lot of extra planning and the well-being and safety of everyone are to be put in place and thought of. And so we are grateful to God for a faithful servant. Now we meet today to give God thanks and to reflect on a life well lived of our beloved Mother Dunstan. We gather also to gain strength from each other and to share in the family's grief. So our condolences goes to the family, to Bishop Opeton and family, to our evangelist Vanessa and family, Sister Doreen and family, extended family, church family, friends. Now, brethren, we're all on a journey, a spiritual journey. And every one of us, whether we want to be on this journey or not, we're on a journey towards our eternal destination. A destination of joy and peace, or a destination of hell, fire, and brimstone. We don't hear that often. Let me read in your hearing Lamentations chapter 3 from 21 to 26 and 31 to 33. This I recall to my mind, therefore I have hope. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul. Therefore will I hope in him. The Lord is good unto them that wait for him, to the soul that seeketh him. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. For the Lord will not cast off forever, but though he cause grief, yet will he have compassion according to the multitude of his mercies. For he doth not afflict willingly, nor grief the children of men. The writer here, the prophet Jeremiah, was burdened by the suffering that surrounded him. However, words of hope and faith and assurance came to him, and he recalled to mind that God is faithful and his mercies are new every morning, day by day, as we reach out to him. We find his sustaining grace and divine favor in our lives. Yes, though we suffer and we grieve, we have tribulations in life. My soul, my very being, trusts in the Lord. He is my portion. He is my shepherd. He is my light and my salvation. He is my present help in the time that I need him most. I know that he will comfort me. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. It's not going to be like this forever. Death, where is thy sting? Grave, where is thy victory? It's not going to be like this forever. There is a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. But though he cause grief, yet will he have compassion according to the multitudes of his mercies. God is an inexhaustible fountain of mercy. The rivers of mercy run fully and constantly, new every morning. Mother Dunstan has made her choice. Her spiritual journey has ended in joy and peace. Now we have a choice to make, because we are on a spiritual journey. So brethren, recall to mind, and make the right choice. God bless you. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. At this time, I'm going to ask our bishop to come and close in prayer. I'm going to say the benediction, and then we'll play when we all get to heaven. If we could just have a sit down or a clap, it depends on how the music is, before we leave. So God bless you, Bishop.
Please bow your heads. Eternal Father, we are grateful because tonight we celebrate her life. We thank you for the near on 93 years that she was loaned to us. We thank you, Father, for how you have used her to help shape our lives, to help mold us, to instruct us, to rebuke where necessary, but always with a heart of love, always with a heart of compassion. We thank you, God. And Lord, we're now entering that chapter where she is not here, but Father, her works live on. Thank you, Father, for her children and in-laws and everybody around her, all her family members. Thank you for the church family, Lord God. Indeed, it has been a privilege to celebrate her life, and we will continue to do so, Lord God, as long as you allow. And I pray finally, Lord God, that the words that we have just heard would register in our hearts. Because, Father, we will not truly celebrate Sister Julina's life until we embrace you, Sister Julina's God. We thank you. We bless you. We praise you now and forever. In Jesus' name, amen.
As we stand, brethren, we'll say the benediction. And it's a favorite benediction. Hallelujah. Now let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen.
While we walk this pilgrim pathway, clouds will open. But when traveling days are over, not the shadows and the sand, when we all have wondered, what a day, what a day, when we all have been on the high, when we all. We'll be right back.